My sister and I have always been mistaken as twins. I'm 19 and she's 16, but we have the same height, skin tone, and similar voice. She also has a habit of being a copycat, from the way I dress to hobbies, even piercings. I know it's cute if you look at it from the outside, but sometimes it gets annoying. Like, yeah, we are quite close too, but why does she always happen to pick up everything I pick up? One afternoon, I was tidying up some costumes in my college showroom and found a rather cute brown and pink wig. It looks like a mushroom. I put it on, think it looks rather funny, so I snapped a picture and posted it to my Instagram. I received a text from my sister asking if I really cut my hair. I didn't mention it was a wig. While I somewhat have a feeling that she might copy that too, I lied and replied yes. I came home that weekend and lo and behold, my sister emerged with the same silly brown and pink bob cut, except this one is on her permanent hair. She was surprised that I arrived with my hair still long, then realized that I lied to her. She was furious that she had to cut that silly hairstyle because she thought I had it. Our parents think that it's a really bad joke and wanted me to cut my hair too to make it up to her. So am I the asshole for telling my sister I cut my hair when I really didn't?
Gel manicure at home using Semolina.
Never play this game with your friends. Once there was a group of girls who heard about the game Baby Blue. They didn't believe in it, but thought they could scare their friend Laura. So they sent Laura into a bathroom by herself. She turned off the lights, closed the door, and put her arms out as if to hold a baby. Then started chanting Baby Blue 13 times. What happened next cannot be explained. Laura felt a heavy weight in her arms. Then she felt the weight in her arms scratching her. She was terrified and didn't know what to do. She wanted to drop it, but she was afraid of what might happen if she did. So she froze, and the weight grew heavier and heavier. Suddenly, she saw a woman in the bathroom mirror with a twisted look on her face. She screamed in terror. When her friends heard her scream, they tried to open the door, but it was locked. When they finally opened the door, they found Laura on the floor. Her eyes had been scratched out. They tried to move her body, but they couldn't, because something large and invisible was pinning her to the ground. Do you style your hair the same way every day? Well, there's an urban legend about a woman who always wore her hair in a bun, but for her, this habit would lead to something terrifying. This woman loved wearing her hair in a bun, but she might have taken it a bit too far. She didn't want to style her hair differently or even take out her bun to clean her hair. Whenever she took a shower, she would just wear a shower cap to make sure the water didn't mess up her bun. At night, she would sleep with a towel around her hair so the bun didn't move. After a while, she had to put hairspray in it to mask the smell. Then her scalp started feeling itchy, so she would put more hairspray in it. Even when the itching got intense, she just applied more hairspray. But her husband finally found out about how bad the situation had gotten when he woke up one day and his wife was still asleep. He tried to wake her up, but she wouldn't move. She had died in the middle of the night. The husband called the police, fearing that something unusual might have happened. But when her body was examined, they finally took out her bun. Inside her hair, they found something terrifying. They found a huge spider had gotten into her hair, made a nest, and laid eggs. When the baby spiders hatched, they bit through her skull and ate her brain.
This is why you need a security system for your house. A few years ago, I was renting a house in Northern California. The neighborhood was just outside of the suburbs. It seemed like the perfect balance of having space and having nice neighbors close enough not to feel isolated. The area had no streetlights, so it was very dark at night, but it didn't bother me. I got home from work one evening in midwinter. It was a cloudy night, so pulling up, I only saw what my headlights and porch light illuminated. When I got out of my car, I caught a whiff of cigarette smoke. That was odd, as I had never smelled that before around my house, but I didn't see anyone nearby, so I ignored it and went inside. I had just gotten off a shift with a few hours of overtime, and I was exhausted. It wasn't even 7 yet, but I decided to call it an early night. I woke up sometime later when I heard a noise inside of my house. I wasn't immediately worried because my best friend had a spare key and would sometimes come over. However, he'd always text me and let me know, but when I checked my phone, there were no messages. I called out my friend's name. There were a few seconds of silence before I heard someone stomping as they ran through the bottom floor. I leapt out of bed and ran to the closet. They were already up the stairs by the time I opened the door and stepped inside. I was terrified. That's when I heard them thunder down my hallway.
Am I the asshole for getting mad about my mom marrying my fiancé's dad?
What?
I, 24 female, and my fiancé, 24 male, have been together since our sophomore year of college, so around 5 years now. For context, my mom had an affair with a coworker when I was 16, leading to my parents' divorce. She has been single ever since. Sadly, my fiancé's mom passed 2 years ago due to cancer, and his dad has been single since. My fiancé proposed last year, but our wedding was delayed due to COVID. 3 months ago, in January 2021, we decided it was time to have our families meet for the first time to discuss our upcoming wedding. This went well. This morning, out of the blue, my mom called me and announced that she had eloped. I was shocked as she had not been dating anyone to my knowledge. Upon questioning, it turns out that she and my fiance's dad had been dating in secret since that meeting in January and had married in secret yesterday, making my fiance my stepbrother. Am I the asshole for not returning my bridesmaid's gift after the wedding was canceled? My friend Jessica, 28 female, was supposed to get married over the summer. She asked me and a few of our other friends to be her bridesmaids by giving us gift boxes. They were really nice. Well, Jessica's fiance got a call from her boyfriend and the wedding was called off. Neither one of them knew about each other. We were all just as blindsided as he was. Jessica recently contacted me to tell me that since the trip isn't happening, she wants the bridesmaid's gift back. When I told Jessica that I had assumed this stuff was a gift, so I'd already used some of it, she got really mad and said that I should have saved it for the trip and that I had to reimburse her for the price of all of the stuff.
What a tacky bitch.
Her and the maid of honor, her sister, are talking a lot of shit in the group chat that I'm stealing from Jessica. Am I the asshole?
Have you let anyone borrow your phone before? One woman let her son borrow her phone, but she could have never expected the terrifying thing she saw after she got her phone back. So this woman got her new phone and she put it on the kitchen counter and went to watch some TV. That's when her son came in and asked if he could borrow the phone to play with it. The woman didn't think much of it at first, so she agreed, but she could have never known that this would lead to a terrifying discovery. When it was nighttime, she got ready to tuck her son into bed, so she went upstairs to his room, but he wasn't there. Then she ran over to her room and saw him sleeping on her bed with the new phone in his hand. She felt relieved, so she took her phone back and started looking through it. At first, nothing was out of the ordinary. She saw her background had changed, but it wasn't until she saw the photos that she found the horrifying surprise. There were many new photos on her phone that her son took around the house, the front door, the kitchen, and even photos of her taken from the back when she was watching TV. She started deleting these photos until the last one caught her eye. Instantly, she turned around, terrified. It was a photo of her son sleeping in her bed, but it was taken by someone else, someone standing above him, and on the edge of the photo was half of a stranger's face.
If you're ever driving late at night, don't do what they did. Two boys picked up a girl on the side of the road while they were on their way to a school dance. In the car, she kept saying that she was cold, so one of the boys gave her his jacket. But when the night ended and they were about to drop her off, the girl accidentally left with the jacket. So the boys said that they would just come back the next day to get it. But when they came back and knocked on her door, they discovered something that would make them question what is real and what isn't. An old woman opened the door and asked them who they were looking for. After talking to her for a while, it was revealed that the girl they found on the side of the road was her daughter. But the thing is, she had been dead for 12 years. She was killed in a car accident at the same street corner they first saw her. The old woman pointed to a cemetery down the road and said, "That's where we buried her." The boys didn't believe her at first. They'd spent the whole night with this girl, so they knew that she had to be real. But they went to the cemetery and saw the boy's jacket draped over a gravestone. And on the gravestone was the girl's name and the date of her death, exactly 12 years ago to the day.
Hi, yeah, very unpopular opinion here. If you would like to get in contact with me, FaceTime me or call me. Do not text me. My boyfriend and friends have a lot to say about this. It's the thing that they complain about the most with me, but I don't think these motherfuckers understand that they are dealing with someone who has ADHD and is not on medication. And an extraordinary procrastination problem. Listen, when I see you text me, I'm like, okay, I'm doing something right now. I'll respond to them in like 3 minutes. Then 3 minutes comes along and I'm doing something else and I completely forget that they texted me. Then it's 6 hours later and they're like, what the fuck? You're on Instagram, but you're not responding to my text. Listen, I forgot. But if you call me or FaceTime me, it's right there. I have no other option but then to feel awkward for denying your call or just answering it on the spot, getting the conversation over with so I can continue my activities. This is not a me issue. This is an everyone else in my life's issue.
This is why you should always keep a diary. Once there was a young woman in Korea who was blind in one eye. She decided that once she saved up enough, she would get a cornea transplant. Eventually she did, so she scheduled the surgery. She was very excited for it. However, afterwards, things took a terrifying turn. She stopped texting and talking to her friends and even her family with no explanation. People thought she just needed some time to recover. However, eventually her parents grew worried about her and went to her house. They knocked on her door, but there was no reply. Then they called the police, who broke down the door. Inside the house, they found the young woman lying in a pool of her own blood. Her parents were devastated. No one could understand why she did this to herself. Perhaps it was just a social isolation. However, this theory was quickly changed when the police kept investigating. All the mirrors had been smashed in the house, as well as all other reflective surfaces. But it wasn't until they found the young woman's diary that they really found out what was happening. When they flipped open her diary, they found that on the last few pages, she'd written over and over again, "My right eye is staring at me."
I wanna touch your body, so fucking electric. I know you're scared of me, you say that I'm too eccentric. I'm crying on my tears and that's fucking pathetic.
Hey man, did you touch my drum set?
Nope.
It's just weird, cause seems like someone definitely touched my drum set.
Yeah, that is weird. Because I didn't touch him.
Hey! Did you touch my drum set?
Hey, knock it off!
I know you touched my drum stick. Because the left one has a chip in it.
You fucking crazy, man. You sound insane. Do you realize that? You should be medicated.
Fuck you, Brennan. I know you touched my drum set, and I want to hear that dirty little mouth admit it.
You get out of my face, or I'm going to roundhouse your ass.
You swear on your mom's life that you didn't touch it then.
I don't have to swear to shit!
You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.
TK Maxx finds this morning.
Call me when you want, call me when you need, call me in the morning, I'll be on the way.
Call me when you want, call me when you need, call me in the morning, I'll be on the way.
If you struggle with eyeliner, then you need to try the Juvia's Place Nubian Intense Pencil Liner. As you can see here, the pencil is really easy to control and it glides across the eyelid so smoothly. I like to buff my liner out, but it dries down completely matte, it's smudge proof and lasts for 12 hours. And here's the finished look, the easiest liner ever.